Hi guys, in this video we are going to solve this problem, prime multiples. So we are given k distinct prime numbers and an integer n, and our task is to calculate how many of first n positive integers are divisible by at least one of the given prime numbers. So n can be up to 10 to power 18, number of prime numbers can be up to 20, and these prime numbers can be up to 10 to power 18. So now let's see how we can solve this problem. So we will start with this simple example. So 20 is our n, which means from 1 to 20 we have to consider two means given prime numbers. So 2 and 5 total two numbers are there. Now we have to tell how many numbers are there which are multiples of 2 and 5, multiples of 2 or 5 more properly. So this union we have to find out for 2 and 5. So this, okay, before calculating this we can just say okay, so let's see how many numbers are multiples of 2. So for 2, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18 and 20, these are multiples. For 5, 5, 10, 15 and 20 are its multiple. Okay, so now if you want to get this 2 union 5, then what we have to do, you can just add these 2 and 5. Okay, but when we are just adding this 2 and 5, then we are also getting duplicates. So like 10 is added twice, similarly 20 is added twice. So these duplicates we need to remove. So these are getting duplicated because this 10 is a multiple of 5 as well, and 2 as well. So what we will do, we will remove duplicate which are multiples of remove numbers which are multiples of 2 and 5. So like this we will do, which is like 10. So for 2 we are having 10, for 5 we are having 4 multiples, and for 10 we are having 2 multiples. So total we will have 12. So this is how we can get answer for simple test case. Now in our case, number of prime numbers can be up to 20. So let's see how we can solve with that. Okay, but before that, let's see this Venn diagram. So we are having these two sets A and B. So if you want to get number of elements in A union B, then what we can do, just we can say like n A, number of elements in A, in set A, and we can add this. So this we can do like n A, and then we can do this n B. And now since this is getting duplicated, so we can remove this one copy of it we can remove. So this we can do like that. Okay, so now let's see how we can generalize this so that we can have something like this, n A union B union, like that for multiples sets, because that is what we want, because we will have more than one prime number, more than two prime numbers. So P1 union P2 union P3 up to PK, that is what we want. So this we can do using inclusion exclusion principles. So let's see how we can do that. So I will just write formula. So if you are having k sets, distinct sets, then for them to get this union, what we can do, we can just take sum of all of AI. I will write it again. Okay, so we can take sum of all of AI, I equal to 1 to n. So this means na1 plus na2 plus na3 like that. Then we can take all of pairs from this and subtract it. So like that, ai intersection aj we can do. Then we can add all triplets in there. Okay, and like that we have to do. At the end we will have minus 1 to power k plus 1 and like this you will have at the end. Okay, so what we are doing here actually is, now we are just picking one set from these all sets, and for those we are just summing them. Then we are picking two of them for from all the sets and we are summing them. Then we are picking three, and then we are picking four, like that. And these signs are alternating. So here initially it is plus, then this is minus, then it becomes plus, then it will become minus, and like that it will go on. Okay, and one thing is, like, if number of sets are odd, then even. So if number of sets are even, then this will be minus negative. If it is odd, then it will be positive. So now let's write this PA1 union A2 union A3 using this inclusion exclusion principle. So this will be an A1 from this first line. So this we can write, just sum them all. Then we have to pick two of them and subtract. So we will pick A1 and A2 first. Then A2 and A3. And then A1 and A3. And then this third, since these are negative, so it will become positive. So this A2, A1, A2, A3 we can add. Okay, so this is how we can get this A1 union A2 union A3 like that. Okay, so and now let's see how we can solve our problem using this. Okay, so first, okay, so here I am going to use a long because our numbers are in 10 to power 18 range. So take n, okay, I will take input and then I will take a primary in which I will input all of those prime numbers. Okay, then what I will do, I will just like this. Okay, and this I will explain you. Okay, so here if you see in this example only, A1 union A2 union A3, we are taking every combination possible from these two sets. So we are taking when only one is there, A1, A2, A3. When only two are there, so A1, A2, A2, A3, A1, A3, like that. And when all of them are there, okay. And we are not counting the set in which no one is there. So empty set we are not considering. So total we are having this 2 to power k minus 1 sets here. Okay, so here in code also we will do the same thing. So we need to consider every combination. Yes, every combination we have to consider. So the way we are going to handle this in code is, so we can take k bits, and these bits are will be corresponding to an integer value. So we can say 0, 1, 2, and up to 2 to power k minus 1 they will be. So here all bits will be 1, and in starting for 0 all bits are 0, and we are assuming them just k bits. Okay, so So if you take just someone from middle, so say for this this weight is 1 0 1 1 0, like that. So what this means is, so if this bit is set here, then this means, so corresponding to this position in our prime array, so that prime number will be there in the number we are picking, okay. And when this is 0, that means that prime number is not there in the number we are picking, so for which we want to calculate multiples. Similarly for this also, and when we are at this end, so this means every prime number is there in the number for which we are interested in finding multiples. Okay, now how do we actually find out number of multiples for a given number? So from 1 to n we have to find out. So if you want to find out for say like 2, so what we can do, just do n by 2 and take integer part of that. Similarly, if we are just having an x number, so what we can do, just take integer part of this n by x, and we will get number of its multiples which we are actually interested in. So okay, now one more thing, this x here will be product of these prime numbers, so it will like this, p1 into say like p2 is not present, so p3 into p4 into say like 5 6 are not present, so p7. Now this p1 p2 are up to 10 to power 18, so if you multiply them and then just divide this n by that, so then it will overflow. So what instead we will do, we will divide this n by p1 first, okay, then we will divide this by p3, then we will divide it by p4, and then by p7, like that we will do, and then we will get number of multiples for this number x or this number. Okay, so now let's again go to the code. Okay, so I will take an temp variable which will be number of multiples, so initially it will be just 1 n, then for each bit in I we will traverse, so there will be k bit in which we are interested. So then I will take an variable and I will store in which I will store number of set bits. So I will just say count set bits, or you can say count sets also, because this will tell number of sets. So initially 0, so then I will see, check, okay, if in that I that bit is there, so if it is there, that means we can increase our count sets by 1, and we can divide this temp by this prime j, because since this jth bit is there, that means this prime j is there. So to calculate number, we can just divide this temp, which is initially n, by prime j. Okay, now here what we can do, we can check if that count sets is odd, so if it is odd, then we can add inside our answer. So answer I will declare here, so answer plus equal to say temp, else if it is even then we will decrease temp. So then we can just see out this. Okay, now input already taken, I'll just check it. Yes, so we are getting to, okay, now let's submit it and check whether it is working or not. So yes, we are getting correct answer. Okay, so in next video we are going to solve this next problem, which is counting coprime pairs. So here also we will be using the same inclusion exclusion principle. So if you you can try this first, and either if you are having any issue, then you can watch this next video. So thank you guys for watching this video. So if you are having any doubt, then you can ask in comment section. Also, if you have any suggestion, then you can put them in comment section. So by that time, thank you guys for watching this video, and I will meet you in the next video.